In this video, I am going to explain fascial connection from head to rest of the body. I want to talk about membrane around brain today. There are three membranes around brain. First membrane is dura mater. Dura mater is the outermost membrane. I will draw dura mater as blue. Next one is arachnoid mater. Arachnoid mater. It is beneath dura mater and it's like a spider web like membrane. Arachnoid means spider, so it's like a spider web like membrane. Arachnoid mater. The innermost membrane is pia mater. Pia mater. Oh, by the way, arachnoid mater is a mistake. I misspelled. Outermost membrane, dura mater. Arachnoid mater, middle layer. Innermost layer is pia mater. I want to focus on dura mater today. Okay. Dura mater is basically everywhere inside of head, and its shape is like literally a contour of brain. It covers cerebrum, which is this part, big part of brain, and it of course covers cerebellum right here. So basically, when you got head trauma from car accident, whiplash, or martial arts trauma, this dura mater can get tight. Let's say this part is tight. This tightness can pull rest of part of dura mater, like this, and like this. When membrane is pulled, there's tension. What happens if there's tension? That can be cause for pain, such as headache, neck pain, neck movement restriction, so many things. That is why I focus on treating dura mater a lot in my practice. If there is no hemorrhage inside of brain, if there's no brain tumors inside of brain, but your dura mater is tight because of head trauma, maybe manual therapy can help that. This is basically why I focus on dura mater a lot. Okay, dura mater is inside of brain. How come membrane around head can affect rest of the body? Okay, again, dura mater covers brain. Then, is brain only the nervous tissue in the body? No. Brain becomes spinal cord, like this, right? And as brain becomes spinal cord, dura mater also continues to spinal cord. Dura mater also covers around spinal cord. Again, what if there is trauma here? And what if dura mater is pulled this way? Maybe dura mater around spinal cord can be pulled to where trauma is. Then what's going to happen? What would happen to tension around dura mater, around cervical spines? Maybe that can be tight. Then what happens to movement of neck? That can be restricted. This fascial connection can go to all the way down to sacrum, because head is like the most superior part of axial skeleton, right? Then sacrum is the most inferior part of axial skeleton. Makes sense. There is a fascial connection top to bottom. Makes sense. Again, that's why I focus on tension of dura mater in my clinic. If there's no hemorrhage, if there's no tumor, but if you have headache, if your dermata is tight, maybe that symptom can be solved by manual therapy. Okay, head to sacrum. Makes sense. But how about rest of the body? Let me explain that. Okay, this is the axial skeleton without head. Head is about here. I said dura mater continues as brain becomes spinal cord, like this. Spinal cord finishes about level of L1, but still, dura mater is around inside part of spine. And dura mater goes to sacrum. That is why dura mater of head gets tight. That can affect rest of the spine. Then, this is not end of the point. Central nervous system becomes to peripheral nervous system, like this, to everywhere to the body. Peripheral nervous system is also covered by membrane. This is not dura mater, but this membrane is also from dura mater. Its name is not dura mater, but it's same thing, same continuous thing. Again, what happens if dura mater of brain gets tight? This tension can go to peripheral nervous system via membrane. That makes sense. Then, what is around the peripheral nervous system? There is muscles around nervous system. So, tightness of dura mater can affect tightness of muscles because of this membranous connection. Not always, but this is high tendency. I think dura mater of brain is kind of a key point for attention of body. I don't know why, but simply it's because there is brain. What is function of brain? Movement, sensation, integration of information, vision, auditory system, and so many things are controlled by brain. So membrane around brain can affect all the part of body. Of course, other part of body can affect rest of body. Like there is abdomen, there is internal organs around abdomen, there is thorax. There's internal organs inside of thorax. There is pelvis. Yep. There are a lot of internal organs inside of pelvis. This internal organ restriction can affect rest of body. Let's say pelvic organ can restrict movement of pelvis, movement of hip joint. Makes sense. And tightness of abdominal internal organ can affect movement of abdomen. It can affect lumbar spines, thoracic spines, of course, because there is also membranous connection. But I don't know why I focus on dura mater a lot, and treating dura mater affects rest of the body. That is why for treatment video, I upload a lot of dura mater treatment video. Okay, so again, tightness of dura mater can affect neck pain, headache, and rest of the body. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.